Mad Max Fury Road has already become one of the biggest movies of the year, and it follows a remarkable trend. On average, over 5 dystopian films have come out every year for the past decade. Why are we so obsessed with dark futures?
And we will all go together when we go. What a comforting fact that is to know.
Mad Max falls into the oldest dystopian subgenre, apocalyptic. The first story ever written, The Epic of Gilgamesh, tells of a flood sent to wipe out humankind. This myth helped the Sumerians cope with an unpredictable river, but modern-day threats are just as real. Global warming is irrefutable, and science and tech leaders warn of a robot takeover. Seeing this in fiction offers some sense of control.
Maybe we need that. Maybe we need some time where we're walking around with a donkey with pots clanging on the sides.
You think that would just bring us back to reality?
Yeah, because everything is amazing right now. And nobody's happy.
If you're ever overwhelmed by the digital age, or by society in general, the end of civilization sounds nice. A post-apocalyptic world not only removes cell phones and other distractions, it's a place where orgies are normal, violent impulses can be exercised, or even justified, and the struggle to survive gives life meaning.
Part of it is, like, it's kind of beautiful when it all goes away, and part of it is kind of terrifying, because everything shifts. You know, the people who are in control, people who are the most comfortable, are suddenly running for their lives and terrified.
Dystopias already exist in the real world, but people don't flock to see movies about them. Joe Queenan at The Guardian points out that dystopian movies are a world where white people get to masquerade as oppressed minorities, like Marie Antoinette dressing up as a penniless shepherdess in Petite Renon. The difference is that today, privileged white people generally acknowledge the importance of human rights. Stories about the powerful becoming powerless are a safe space to examine real-world injustice.
Dystopia, by virtue of the description of that, is that it's built in conflict. If it's utopia, then it's like, oh, that's nice. You know, I can't wait for the future because it's going to be nice.
Dystopian films are most common during peacetime. Fritz Lang's Metropolis came out of Germany's Weimar Republic, the rebuilding period between world wars. America produced swells of dystopian movies in the mid-1970s and 1990s after exiting Vietnam and the Cold War. It seems tragedy plus time equals cautionary sci-fi tales. Whether you decide that reality will never get that bad, or that it's already too late, dystopias help us make sense of a rapidly changing world. And as dark as they are, most of them are optimistic. They tell us that humans can survive anything, and that no matter how strange the future may be, we will always be recognizably human, with the same flaws and aspirations we've always had.